we're suffering in a way where we can't communicate with them, you know, but they're suffering in a way where they can't, they see us, but they can't talk to us, you know, like
they're desperate to talk. They want people to know here that they're all right, and they're not dead.
Yeah,
that they're living a better life actually than the life here. You know,
they don't have to be floating around and ghosts and always be in your living room and you know, like that. There's other options, especially you know, in the spirit world.
There's a lot of options.
Yes, you're open to pretty much
anything.
Go on back, you know, to you know, back, well, you can imagine whatever you want, you know.
And then it comes true.
Yeah,
just like
creating your reality. You know?
Creating your reality instantly.
Yeah,
right. Same thing that happens here, but it's most people happen to the slower level here. It's not instant in this world unless you evolve to a certain level.
I think it's a good thing, I would say, to try to recognize karma in your life. You know, if anything, to help you see things, it's recognize karma in your life. You know, if you can start seeing that and knowing when you receive bad and good, that it's part of your karma. You
accept
know?
It all.
Yeah.
You have to, that's a good point right there.
I was just trying to say that, you know.
Accept everything as a meaningful part of your life. Yeah, even if it seems like some shitty negative thing.
Yeah.
Go ahead and accept it anyway and be happy with it.
You got to. That's why people are like, why are you, you know, so open-minded to the idea of death? Well, because it's part of life.
That's right.
It's not that it's part of life and there's no end anyway, but there's plenty of examples of why, you know, you can't be afraid of death, but
it's just an illusion.
Human conditioning again. But
that's very much so.
We all are equal, you know, so we do have our fear of death.
That's correct.
But to try to face it a little bit, okay, to, you know.
Yeah, because like it's so much more to it, you know. I mean, like, and when we, you know, all you guys have lived lots of lives and all that too. We've all lived plenty of times, but you just don't remember it at the moment.
No,
not all of you probably, but
no, and maybe some of you are. You're just not recognizing it, you know, or just you know, you're just illuminating the thought and saying, no, that's just a thought, an illusion. You know,
make believe.
But you're actually thinking of something that, wow, it really happened. You know, you're just passing the thought by. You know, you know
instead of recognizing it for the reality it is.
It's the truth. You know, it's the truth. I mean, we're so full of truth. You know, and children, man, they're really full. You know,
children for sure. You know, children can see so much.
They're smart.
And then, but a lot of people, parents, talk down to them and think they're idiots and all. But actually, they're full-grown spirits, just as grown as all of us. You know, they just happen to have a little body at that moment, but they have a lot of knowledge, and they can see a lot if you talk with them.
Yeah, I've had a few interesting conversations with my own children. I'm talking about leaving their bodies and seeing spirits and things like that. And I didn't even prompt them or ask them anything about it. You know, they just started talking about it, you know. And once one of them started talking about it, the other one started talking about it. It was weird, you know. I was looking at them like, well, maybe they take after me a little bit, you know. But it was cool. But it's just, I think, you know, you forget as you get older, though, and you lose it. You know, you lose that ability. You forget to think you saw monsters or whatever. I don't know. I think.
Let me check this video because, like, I just remembered, like, I'm just letting this conversation go where it's going. I just want to check the time. Because we put these videos up on YouTube and Facebook, but I just remembered that the videos that go over 20 minutes won't post on Facebook correctly.
Okay.
Well, we need to see where it's at. We need to put a timer. Yeah, we could just do part two if we got to. All right, it's about to start 13 minutes.
Okay.
Seven more minutes left in this one. I'm going to switch to part two.
We'll do a few more minutes and then we'll part two.
Yeah, just the way. We're still going to have to split it up and put it on YouTube anyway. Well, anyway, let's get back to the subject. I just remember that. Little things like that are psychic things, though, too. Like, you know, I get reminders like that all the time. It'll just pop up at exactly the right moment. Like, remember this, remember that, do this, do that. Right. And it's not just remembering things, not every time. Sometimes it's more than that.
Exactly. It's just it's telling you something, you know.
But, you know, we've had good.
I just it's like feeling energy, you know what I'm saying? That's all.
This whole room, like I was about to say earlier, like we got an audience in here, you know?
Yeah.
You know, like spirits are coming over here, what we're saying right now, are just watching us, you know? I kind of saw them, felt them earlier, they're still here, you know? I mean, and sometimes they chime in, you know?
Yeah, I feel that, you know. I always feel I have your presence, I see you, you know. That's what I've told, you know, somebody before that. I felt like, you know, a lot of times they're like bored looking at me and I'm bored of looking at them, so they don't say anything. It's not like they're really always ready just to jump out and say something, because they're not used to meeting somebody and communicating with them. So when I get that connection with them and say, hey, let's communicate, they're ready sometimes. Sometimes they're passive. They don't need to communicate.
Yeah.
They don't even want to, you know, and people say, well, why would they not want to communicate? Well, some days I don't want to communicate.
Yeah.
You know,
maybe they just wanted to see what was going on.
Yeah.
About him for a minute.
Yeah. And they got their own fears to deal with about that, you know. Who knows, you know.
They got their own issues still.
Yeah. You know, it's just, it depends on where they're at, you know.
It doesn't change, you know, like, you know, when you die, or, well, more correctly, it's probably like a dimensional change.
You're right.
That's all that really happens. But, you know, just like you go into a dream when you're asleep, and sometimes it seems as real as living, you know. Probably the same thing, but a lot realer, you know.
Yeah.
You know, just you shift off, and then it's just, well, anyway,
yeah,
just like that.
Yeah, you'd be living, you know, every thought you have, so you would almost feel like you would be taken over by a dream state, probably, you know.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's what it would feel like, but you would actually be doing it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, it would be like so, you know. But like I said, you know, I don't want people to get the wrong idea about life and death. That's not the issue. Living and dying, you know, are part of life every day.
That's right.
You know, you can't fear it. Because everyone ceases, and everyone is born, you know.
That's right.
You know, so we know those two things.
Yeah, but the thing to remember is that the dying part isn't real ceasing to be. It's not at all. You might cease to live in a body for a minute, a physical one, but it doesn't really matter. You're still there.
Yeah, you keep going on. I think we should
just start part two.
Yeah.
And let's close this one out here.
Yeah, we'll come back to you guys, you know, with more of this, you know.
We got a lot more to say. This is just the beginning. So.
Yeah. And we're just keeping the time limit straight, and we'll be back.
All right.